Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hi everyone, welcome back to the PL-300 exam preparation course, and we are talking about our first learning path, prepare the data. So we are going to continue our discussion on the first topic, identify and connect to our data source, which is part of the section get data from data sources. So in this video we are going to focus on connecting to a JSON file. JSON is a very famous structure that is used to save semi-structured data. So previously we saw that for the CSV and for the Excel file, we have data in the structured form where we have data in the form of rows and columns. So in JSON, the structure is not the rows and columns, but the file saves data in a way that this structure can be converted into a row and column format. So that is how the JSON structure works. And now today we are going to connect to a JSON file and see how this conversion takes place in Power Query Editor. So let's go back to the Power Query Editor now. So I am back in the Power Query Editor using the same file that we used in the last video. And now I'm going to click on new source here. And here I see that I cannot find the JSON connector in this list. So I need to go and click on this more option here. So after a few seconds, you see that this get data window has now popped up, and here I can see different options on the left, and on the right I can see all the available connectors. So here you can see that I can find the JSON connector, and it says import data from JSON document. So I'm just going to go and click on the connect button here. So here we are inside the same folder that we used for the previous video, and here I can see that there is a JSON document or a JSON file, Apple iPhone 11 reviews, and I just need to go and select this, and then I need to go and click on open. Apple iPhone 11 reviews queries is shown in the queries area here, and I can see the data from the JSON file has been converted into a proper table with a row and column structure. So now let's see in the applied steps area what actually these four steps actually have done, where the structure of a JSON file has been converted into a proper table. So if I go on the source applied step, so here you see that in the formula bar I can see the function json.document, and again it refers to the file path where the JSON file is. And here in this area you are actually going to see just one particular column, which says list, and inside this list you have, for every row you have records. So if you take your mouse to these rows, you see that these are clickable records. You don't need to go and click on this, but just click on the blank area in any of these rows, and as soon as you click on the blank area, not on the URL or not on the hyperlink, you are going to find that there is a preview that is shown on the bottom. So here is the preview. So if you go and see, this record actually specifies product, helpful count, total comments, URL, and review country. So for all these records, actually each record represents these columns, and these columns actually have these entries that you are going to find. So this is something which we haven't seen so far in the previous video. So this is something which is different. Next, I am going to click on the next applied step, which is the convert it to table. And here you can see that now the list has converted to a table. So instead of a list, I am just seeing a table. And again, if I go and click on the blank area for any of the rows, again I am going to see the same kind of view. One more thing that you would have noticed is that for the single column that is shown here, now I see an expander. So I can see that there is an expander icon here, which actually allows me to click here and I can expand this. But I am not going to do it here. all I'm going to do is that I'm going to go to the next step, which says expanded column one. So here, if you go and see that now the step where the expansion had to be done, that has been done automatically. And here you can see that the single column has been expanded into 11 columns. And all of these columns actually represent the data that was shown once I clicked on the previous step. So here, if I clicked on this blank area, these were the columns that were already present in the record. And now I can see those columns in the expanded form here. And if I go and click on the last step, you can see that only the data types have been changed. So previously the data type was not assigned, and now each column has a data type assigned, which Power Query automatically detects. Although this is a bit off topic and should not be considered as part of the PL-300 exam, but for general understanding of the M script in Power Query, you need to have an understanding of list, records and tables. First, let's have a look at what records are. So records are enclosed in these square brackets and normally have a name and a value. So here A is a name and 1 is a value, and there is an equality sign in between. And you can have many such pairs, name value pairs with comma in between. So A is equal to 1 is one pair and B is equal to is another pair. Then the next structure type is a list, which is represented by these curly brackets. And a list can have any value. So it can have a number, it can have a record. So here it is, the example shown here has three numbers, 1, 2, and 3, but I could put any number of records inside a list. But the limitation with a list is that if you have a look at a list in Power Query, all you would see is a single column. Our end goal in Power Query for most operations is to make a table. So the last structure type is a table, which is represented by the keyword hash table. And then we have these round brackets, and within the table you would have a long list of lists. So here, if you see that I have a list XY, which where X represents the name of the column, which is X, and the name of the column Y, and then these are the values or the records for the column XY. So it would be XY, then the first record 01, and then the second record 10. So these are some of the structure types that you need to know just for your knowledge while you are working in Power Query Editor and you are trying to do something with the M script.